हेलो एवरीवन, वंस अगेन शोभा वेलकम यू टू आवर शोभाज नॉलेज हब. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट दिल्ली सल्तनत. इट इज अ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक. मैक्सिमम क्वेश्चंस आर आस्क्ड फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक. वी विल एक्सप्लेन यू इन अ वेरी इजी वे. बिफोर एक्सप्लेनिंग द टॉपिक आई विल गिव यू सम बैकग्राउंड. बिफोर टर्क्स, many small kingdoms they were ruling in India. They were fighting among themselves. There were no central ruler, and whoever were coming to India, they were coming only for plundering and to loot India's wealth. Turkey logon ke aane ke pehle jo bhi hamare desh mein aate the wo hamare desh ka dhan loot ke jaate the. They did not want to expand their territories. एक एग्जाम्पल मैं आपको मोहम्मद गजनवी का देती हूँ. ही अटैक अवर सोमनाथ टेम्पल इन गुजरात 17 टाइम एंड लूटेड ऑल द वेल्थ फ्रॉम इट. ओनली मोहम्मद गौरी ही ट्राइड टू एक्सपांड हिज किंगडम. इन फर्स्ट बैटल ही वॉज डिफीटेड बाई पृथ्वीराज चौहान, बट इन नेक्स्ट बैटल ही डिफीटेड पृथ्वीराज चौहान बाई द हेल्प ऑफ हिज स्लेव कुतुबुद्दीन ऐबक. वन मोर थिंग आई वॉन्ट टू लेट यू नो, दिस तुर्की पीपल दे वर सेलिंग देयर सन टू द किंग्स फॉर बेटर एडुकेशन एंड द किंग्स वर टेकिंग देम ड्यूरिंग द टाइम ऑफ वॉर. नाउ वी विल फोकस ऑन द पॉलिटिकल हिस्ट्री ऑफ दिल्ली सल्तनत. देयर वर फाइव मेन रूलिंग डायनेस्टी इन दिल्ली: स्लेव, खिलजी, तगलक, सैयद and Lodi. Main important rulers and the main important dynasty we are going to take today. Slave dynasty. Who were the ruler of slave dynasty? Those who were the slave of Turks or the son of slave. Kutubuddin Aibak, his ruling period 1206 to 1210. His capital was Lahore. He was given the title of Lakh Baksh. He was liberal in distributing money and wealth. He conquered the fort of Bundelkhand and Anhilwar in Gujarat. He laid the foundation of Qutub Minar in Delhi. Listen to my sentence properly. He laid the foundation, not made. Next one, Iltutmish. He was the slave of Qutubuddin Aibak and the son-in-law also. He ruled between 1211 to 1236. He completed the construction work of Qutub Minar. He appointed his daughter as a ruler after him, Nawrajiya Sultana. She was the first Indian woman ruler in Indian history. Many Turks noble, they objected that she should be as a ruler. It was against their tradition. She ruled only for few years. Now we are moving to Khilji dynasty. Founder of Khilji dynasty, Jalaluddin Khilji, he ruled for few years. He was the last king of slave dynasty. He was killed by his nephew, Alauddin Khilji. Now we are talking about Alauddin Khilji. He ruled between 1299 to 1316. He massacred his Mongolian rebellions. He expanded his territory by conquering others' territory. He had a strong army. His policies, very important topic. His market policy we will discuss first. He fixed the cost of all commodities. Example, cloth, food grains, oil. He set up three markets, one for the food grains at Delhi, second one for costly cloth, third one for horse, slave and cattle. We'll see the other policies. Nobles were not allowed to enjoy the party. Gambling, intoxication was prohibited. He appointed spy to check on them. His military reform, strong army, high quality of horses, identification of soldiers, soldiers were paid in cash, revenue reform, he brought the land under his control, he started measuring the land, he increased the land revenue. He did not expand up to the South Kingdom because it was difficult to manage. He was interested only to collect the wealth. Now we will discuss about the Tughlaq dynasty, matlab Tughlaq Samrajya. Founder hai Ghazi Malik. Unko title mila tha Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq. He ruled for few years and he died in 1325. Uske baad mein his son Muhammad bin Tughlaq, he was a ruler. We are discussing about Muhammad bin Tughlaq. He was a great scholar, philosopher, mathematician and was fond of music and Persian literature. He was a man of ideas, always changing his ideas. Uske dimag mein idea aate hi rehte the aur baar baar wo change karta hi rehta tha. He shifted his capital to Devgiri from Delhi and renamed it Daulatabad. Daulatabad was centrally located and was good for controlling the South territories, and Delhi was always invaded. Again he decided to shift his capital to Delhi because of northwest threat. Beside this, he introduced bronze token against the silver token because shortage of silver. Later on, he introduced the leather currency. So many ideas was in his mind. He was a man of idea, that it proves. He improved irrigation system to fight against flood and famine. He distributed free grains and advanced to soldiers. He organized a huge army who were paid in cash. Now we are focusing about the administration of Delhi Sultanate. All powers belong to king, monarch system. Sultans, they were keeping watch on expenditure and revenue. They have set up two important departments, Diwani Insha, dealing with the state activities, Diwani Risalt, deal with the religious matter, Qazi was the head. Ikta system, grant in revenue given to some person, they had provincial and local government also. Our topic is completed today. I hope you understood the topic very nicely. Very soon, we are going to upload our next videos. आप सबको एक बार फिर याद दिला दे, प्लीज सब्सक्राइब एंड लाइक माई चैनल. थैंक यू.